Hello there, Japan fans, Mick Karen fans. Today we are going to do Automatic Gun from Obscure Alternatives. I really like this album. I know a lot of people don't, but I do. This first fretless expedition for Mick on album as well. The previous album, Adolescent Sex, was fretted bass. And this is the first track. So I remember playing it and thinking, oh, wow, what's that sound? So we're going to go through what it is today. It's typical Mick in the sense that it's easy and hard at the same time. So we'll do what we normally do, which is where I'm going to play along, and then I'll tell you what he was doing. Okay, hang tight. Okay, so what's he doing? Well, I'm glad you asked. I watched a lot of videos, and it's not always possible to see exactly where he is, but I think I'm fairly accurate on this. So what we do is we're going to go onto the A string on the 7th fret, and there's a build up with the drum. So the riff starts. And you hear this build up in the background. Now, the reason I think it's here on the 7th fret is because when the bass riff comes in, he's going to go here to the 9th fret on the G string. Like I say, I watched as many videos as I could as well. So I'm pretty sure this is accurate. So after the build-up, the bass line starts. So what he's actually doing is he's playing that note that we started on, 7th fret on the A string. Now, we're going to jump an octave. I think he uses the index finger to do it, and I'll show you why I think that, but you can use whatever finger is handy, okay? And that twice. And you're going to slide that down to the 7th fret. So the 9th fret on the G to the 7th fret. So, ba, ba. So from the top. Now, the reason I think it's his index finger is when you watch videos, he tended to play like that a lot. But the other reason is this next little riff is actually strangely tricky to get under your finger, even though it's really, it should be easy. These are new flat wounds. I got them on another bass. I don't know what they are, and they're kind of draggy. So you'll have to forgive my playing today. But, you know, the old saying goes, those who can do and those who can't teach. So anyway, 7th fret, go from the top, and then 2 up here on the 9th fret, and sliding down to the 7th fret on the G string. Now, I use my 3rd finger to do this next bit. You go your 3rd finger on the 9th fret on the G string, and you're going to slide down to the 7th. Okay, so from the top. And then back up. So, right. So, those 3 notes you play, it's just one note with your finger, and the slides do the rest of it. So, so from the top, and then the note you started on, which is the 7th fret on the A. Okay, so. And then sometimes, to get back to that, he goes to the 7th fret on the E string. And then 2 here. So, like, when you're playing the riff in the context of the verse, it's. And then sometimes you do the triplet for the first thing. Okay, that's the verse, that's it. So the real tricky thing is to get the accuracy of this. Now, I have little fingers, so it's always been a problem for me getting around bass guitar. His fingers are hugely long. You get that. Maybe you could use your little finger. Maybe, yeah. Anyway, you'll figure out which finger is more comfortable for you to use. Okay, so now we're going to do the chorus. Okay, onto the chorus. For once, this is easy, so we're going to play along because it's probably 50 minutes since this out of video, me starting talking. So we'll play along, I'll stop it, and then I'll tell you what he's doing. Real simple, this one. Boxes to reply. Okay, that note was a surprise to me when I listened to work it out. Okay, so what he's doing is real simple. Again, this E on the A string, 7th fret on the A string. Oh, you. And we're going to go to the 9th fret on the D string. Find love. And he's back to that 4th note. Inside. And then the 6th fret on the D string, an automatic gun. So it's, an automatic gun, that's it. So 7th fret on the A, 9th fret on the D, two notes, ba-da, and then back down, ba-ba, 6th fret on the D. Nice and handy. Our left now is the middle eight kind of breakdown thing where you got all the voices, all the radio voices come in, and Sylvie and the same, all sorts of mad stuff. Mick is just playing harmonics over that bit, so what we'll do is play along and I'll show you real quick. All right, so all that is he comes in on the E, which is the 7th fret on the A string. And then, now, if you don't know how to do harmonics, there's lots of them, lessons about it on the YouTubes. So what he's doing is he's playing the harmonic at the 12th on the A, and the harmonic on the 12th on the D. Then he hits this one, which is the 7th fret on the G. And I don't know what he's saying now. No, 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 no. And then you got the build up again, like the intro. Beating on my brain skull. Oh, I hate these strings. These have to go. Okay, that is automatic gun, all the bits and pieces. As always, thanks for watching. And if you have any requests, put them in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And thanks for staying aboard. Which brings me to this question for you. Only something like 27% of people are subscribed who regularly watch. If you wouldn't mind subscribing, that would give me a bit of a help with the algo, as they say. And till then, keep caring and fret less.